I just want to let you guys know that I'm stepping down as the pastor of Steadfast Baptist Church, and I love you guys.
In January 2019, Pastor Donnie Romero resigned from Steadfast Baptist Church in Fort Worth, Texas. At that time, Stephen Anderson stepped in and installed Jonathan Shelley as the new pastor of the three Steadfast churches, Fort Worth, Texas, Jacksonville, Florida, and Oklahoma City, Oklahoma.
This is your new pastor.
Jonathan Shelley had previously been pastoring the Pure Words Baptist Church in Houston, Texas. This placed Shelley as the pastor of four new IFB churches. Prior to Shelley taking control of Steadfast, Stephen Anderson had been accusing Adam Fannin of Steadfast Jacksonville of partaking in Donnie Romero's sins, including stealing money from the church. Anderson announced that the Steadfast financial accounts records and bank accounts were being turned over to the third member of the Steadfast Church Board of Directors. Romero and his wife were the other two members and had resigned from the board. Additionally, Anderson announced that a forensic accountant from outside the church was being called in to examine all of the Steadfast financial accounts records in order to uncover any evidence of fraud. Upon Shelley taking control of Steadfast, however, he took control of all financial accounts and records, fired the third board member, who was a founding member of the church, by the way, and canceled the investigation by the outside forensic accountant. So with all of this in mind, on August 3rd, 2018, Jonathan Shelley purchased a home in Missouri City, Fort Bend County, Texas, a suburb of Houston, securing a mortgage loan in the amount of $130,000 from the Better Mortgage Corporation. In January 2019, after living in his new home for approximately 5 months, Jonathan Shelley put it up for sale in anticipation of moving to Fort Worth, Texas, to assume control of the three Steadfast Baptist churches. On March 8, 2019, Shelley sold his Missouri City home for $224,753. With this money, he paid off his mortgage loan of $130,000, leaving him with a net profit of approximately $94,753. On March 19, 2019, Jonathan Shelley purchased a home in Grand Prairie, Tarrant County, Texas, a suburb of Dallas-Fort Worth, for $356,250. He secured a mortgage loan in the amount of $285,000 from Provident Lending Associates, leaving a remaining balance of $71,250 for Shelley to pay for the standard 20% down payment. Subtracting this from the $94,753 left over from the sale of his previous home, this left Shelley with a balance of $23,503. Typically, home buyers will pay between 2 and 5% of the purchase price for closing costs. Shelley's closing costs would have been between $7,125 and $17,812.50. Given that Shelley was taken for a ride on this new home of his, paying significantly more than the actual total market value, according to the Tarrant County Appraisal District, of $287,986, it is likely that he paid the higher amount in closing costs, thus leaving him $5,690 and change out of his profit from the sale of his Missouri City home. Almost immediately after purchasing his new home in Grand Prairie, Texas, Jonathan Shelley decided to completely remodel his new home, hiring a private contractor and signing a contract for the complete demolition of the home, of additions, the installation of new floors and walls, paint, electrical, plumbing, rafters, and more. During the months of March, April, and May of 2019, Shelley quickly ran up a bill with the new contractor totaling at least $172,219. Between April 8th, 2019 and May 20th, 2019, a period of only 43 days, Jonathan Shelley wrote a series of at least 7 checks, plus one cashier's check, totaling $100,000. Now remember, after paying the down payment on his new home, plus closing costs, he was left with the balance of $5,690 from the sale of his previous home, not $100,000. Of course, this begs the question, where did Shelley find $94,310? To be honest, we don't know. Maybe a rich uncle died and left it to him. Maybe he scrimped and saved all his pennies and dimes. Maybe he found it in the couch cushions. Who knows? However, paying the contractor $100,000 still left Shelley owing him $72,219, an amount that to date, today, April 20th, 2020, almost 1 year later, Jonathan Shelley has still refused to pay. To coin a phrase, Shelley ripped him off. By definition, Jonathan Shelley is a thief. As a result of Shelley's refusal to pay the contractor for his work and materials, the contractor has been forced to file a mechanics and materialman's lien on Shelley's new home. Shelley has received notices of this impending lien on June 11, 2019, June 28, 2019, and July 11, 2019. When he continued to refuse to pay what he owed, the lien was filed and Shelley received a copy of this. No doubt his mortgage company has also received notice of this lien. But as Billy Mays used to say in his late-night infomercials, but wait, there's more. At about the same time Jonathan Shelley purchased his new home and hired a contractor to remodel it, he also announced to his congregation at Steadfast Baptist Church in Fort Worth, Texas, that it had become necessary to move the church to the area of Arlington, Texas. And he began a Move the Church to Arlington offering fund, relying on the congregation to cover the expenses of moving the church. Soon thereafter, Shelley informed the congregation that he had located a site, but that a contractor would have to be hired in order to make the space acceptable for a church. Money naturally began to come in for this purpose. After a period of time, the move was suddenly canceled. The money placed into the move offering fund was not refunded. It was just gone. A source inside of Steadfast Fort Worth provided an address for the location of Shelley's proposed new site for the Steadfast Baptist Church. A Google search of the address, however, revealed it was nothing more than a self-storage facility. So unless he planned on setting up a church in a storage unit, there would literally be no place for Steadfast Church. So what was he thinking? What was his plan? And when you ask these questions in light of the other questions, such as where did all the money from the moving fund go and where did Shelley get the $100,000 to pay the contractor, it seems that the conclusion would be obvious. However, to give Shelley the benefit of the doubt, perhaps he is just completely inept when it comes to money and is simply unable to manage his home and his churches. Remember, he had that time for churches to manage, all receiving tithes, offerings, and online donations. What is certain, however, is that both Shelley and his wife know, and the Lord knows. And even if his church does not know what Shelley is doing, or where the moving fund money went, or where he found $100,000 to pay for home remodel. That all being said, there is yet another aspect to this that has not been explored, and that is the issue of tithes, offerings, and online donations coming in from his other churches. While Shelley is not willing to allow us access to his Steadfast Fort Worth church financial records, nor those for his Pure Words church in Houston, unbeknownst to Jonathan Shelley, a church member from Steadfast Baptist Church, who for obvious reasons would like to remain unnamed, was actually willing to share some financial records with us from Steadfast Church OKC, as well as some information regarding those finances. This individual from Steadfast Church reports that the financial records at Steadfast OKC were, quote, meticulously kept and reconciled, unquote. However, once those records of the accounts were turned over to Jonathan Shelley, the source states, quote, either weren't transferred over or were only done partially so. I know this because my personal tithes from that period weren't included in the year-end giving statement, unquote. This person went on to report that previously, before Jonathan Shelley, the financial information was sent to the accountant on the board of directors at Steadfast Baptist of Fort Worth, and, quote, everything was being handled without incident, unquote. This individual then went on to question whether or not there was a cover-up of sort, and maybe that is why Stephen Anderson, quote, apparently needed to get one of his boys in charge of Steadfast ASAP, and maybe that's why Shelley and Anderson wanted Fannin out ASAP, and maybe that's a factor in Shelley wanting the leadership at Steadfast OKC out and someone less attentive to the finances and with more allegiance to him in place as a leader in OKC. I don't know. Or maybe Shelley just handles his accounts like he handles his congregants, with only token attention and effort. All I know for sure regarding the financial records is that they were not flawlessly transferred or transcribed after they were handed off to Shelley, unquote. And there's still one more aspect to all of this regarding Jonathan Shelley, or rather, Pastor Jonathan Shelley, and that is his position as the pastor of three different churches in three different locations, Houston, Fort Worth, and Oklahoma City, three since Steadfast Jacksonville has recently been taken away from Shelley and given to Pastor Patrick Boyle of Revival Baptist Church in Claremont, Florida. According to Scripture, a pastor is required to be blameless and of good behavior, and have a good report of them which are without, lest he fall into reproach in the snare of the devil. A lover of hospitality, a lover of good men, sober, just, holy, and temperate, 1 Timothy 3, 2 and 7, Titus 1, 6 and 8. As has been proven beyond any shadow of a doubt, Jonathan Shelley is none of these things. He is, at best, a thief, a liar, covetous, certainly not blameless, certainly not of good behavior, certainly not just or holy or lover of hospitality, and he most certainly does not have a good report of them outside the church. That much is not only clear, but clearly documented. Therefore, at the very least, the question must be answered, why is Jonathan Shelley allowed to remain as the pastor of three separate churches when he obviously does not meet the biblical qualifications set forth by God? According to the Texas Quarterly Housing Report for 2019, the average cost of a modest single-family home in Texas is $230,000. Jonathan Shelley paid $356,250 for his home and then added $172,219 worth of remodeled upgrades to it, thus making it a $528,469 home. That makes Jonathan Shelley's new home worth 129.77% more than the average home in Texas. This seems to be exactly what Stephen Anderson, the man who ordained Shelley and then sent him out to start one church and then installed him over three more churches, is adamantly against. Anderson says, quote, "Another bad reason to go into the ministry is money. Some people just might want to become a pastor because they want to get paid. They just see it as a way to make good money. Maybe they're not making it very well in the secular world when it comes to finances, and they just want to make more money, so they just want to get a job being a pastor so they can make money. Or worse yet, so they can get access to money that's not theirs and steal money like a Judas Iscariot. That's even worse," unquote. Let me repeat that last part. Quote, "Or worse yet, so they can get access to money that's not theirs and steal money like a Judas Iscariot. That's even worse," unquote. Anderson goes on, quote, "A greedy, covetous person, someone who desires riches, should never become a pastor," unquote. Anderson preached this in a sermon on April 7th, 2019, right when Shelley purchased his new home and began his massive and expensive remodel of it. Did Anderson know about this? And is this his way of expressing regret over ordaining Shelley? Or maybe this is just coincidence? Anderson continued, quote, "And you know what? You're never going to find me living in a fancy house, driving a fancy car, or wearing fancy clothes," unquote. "A fancy house like Shelley's now more than $500,000 home?" He went on, quote, "But you know what? As a pastor, how do you make these giant windfalls of money, honestly, as a pastor? You don't," unquote. Like the $100,000 Shelley mysteriously came up with. Again, we don't know. It is possible he simply found it hidden in the cushions of his couch. Anderson concluded with, quote, "I don't think pastors should be living in poverty. I think they should have enough money to support their family and get by and live a modest, normal, decent life. A sensible life," unquote. A modest, normal, decent life? A sensible life? $500,000 home is modest and sensible, right? And this is almost a reiteration of something Anderson taught in a sermon almost 3 years prior on October 20th, 2016, when he said, quote, "Now obviously, God does say that preachers should be able to live with the gospel and have a place to live and have food and have drink and have a wife and have children and be able to live a normal, modest life, but not to become rich. If a businessman becomes a millionaire through honest work, which rarely happens, but let's say that happens, great. But that's different because he's not a servant of Christ working for the church. He's out making money, and the sky's the limit. And even he should give and be ready to distribute, willing to communicate, the Bible says, and that he should give of his funds unto the Lord and give to those who are in need and so forth. I mean, the Bible's clear on that," unquote. For all of the new IFB's condemnation of pastors who live extravagantly, it seems just a bit hypocritical for someone who is supposed to be a humble man of God, who is supposed to be content with all things, according to Philippians 4:11, to add $172,219 worth of remodeling to an already expensive home in one of the better neighborhoods in Grand Prairie, Texas. Shouldn't have Jonathan Shelley purchased a modest home and used all of that extra money to feed and clothe and house the poor, the hungry, the naked, the homeless?
"He that hath pity upon the poor lendeth unto the Lord, and that which he hath given will he pay him again. Whoso stoppeth his ears at the cry of the poor, he also shall cry himself, but shall not be heard." Then shall he say also unto them on the left hand, Depart from me, ye cursed, into everlasting fire, prepared for the devil and his angels. For I was an hungered, and ye gave me no meat. I was thirsty, and ye gave me no drink. I was a stranger, and ye took me not in. Naked, and ye clothed me not. Sick, and in prison, and ye visited me not. Then shall they also answer him, saying, Lord, when saw we thee an hungered, or a thirst, or a stranger, or naked, or sick, or in prison, and did not minister unto thee? Then shall he answer them, saying, Verily I say unto you, inasmuch as ye did it not to one of the least of these, ye did it not to me. And these shall go away into everlasting punishment, but the righteous into life eternal.
With that in mind, how Christ-like is it for someone in a position where they are to mirror Christ, striving to own a home that is worth more than 129% of the average home in that state?
And a certain scribe came and said unto him, Master, I will follow thee whithersoever thou goest. And Jesus saith unto him, The foxes have holes, and the birds of the air have nests, but the Son of Man hath not where to lay his head.
What you're likely thinking of is, what is this humble home of Shelley's that he keeps prattling on about? How are we to even know if what he says is even true? Well, let's take a look, shall we? According to the real estate listing, the same listing that Jonathan Shelley would have looked at and that drew him to this home, it is described as meticulously maintained custom home with 4 bedrooms, 2.5 baths, 2 living areas, and a study in Nottingham Estates. Huge covered front porch and mature trees add to the curb appeal of this gem. Textured walls, fresh paint, light fixtures are just a few of the recent updates. A large family room with built-ins, brick walls surrounding the fireplace and a skylight, huge second living area, wood-like laminate floor, and a wet bar area, currently not being used for one. Spacious master bedroom with a huge master closet. Master bath completely remodeled with granite, square tub, dual sinks, separate shower, and travertine tile floors. Roof replaced and exterior of home repainted in 2016. Minutes from DFW Airport. What exactly did Jonathan Shelley's $356,250 buy him? And how bad was it that he found it necessary to hire a contractor to do a $172,719 remodel upgrade to it? Well, again, let's take a look. And if you can decide, if you are able to find anything that is undesirable and in need of remodeling, bearing in mind that these photos are from the home's listing when Shelley purchased it, the furnishings do not belong to the Shelleys themselves. Did you notice anything that needed to be remodeled? Obviously, Jonathan Shelley did. This home was not good enough for him, so he ordered it remodeled to be more to his liking. Again, there are questions that need to be asked, such as, how did Jonathan Shelley come up with $100,000 to pay for the remodeling of his new home? And what happened to the church moving fund? And more importantly, now that it has been documented that Jonathan Shelley is in fact a thief, how long will Stephen Anderson wait before he steps in and removes the now disqualified Jonathan Shelley from his position of the pastor of Two Steadfast Churches and the Pure Words Church?